This is just a little test video. I'm testing out my new camera setup as well as some colours that I'm going to use in a workshop this afternoon. I'm using MAD resin, MAD, M-A-D. And I've got a little bit too much in there. I want 200 of each for this board. Carefully tipping some back. That's close enough. So this is the resin I'm using. Upside down. There you go. I think, but I can always make coasters with what's left over. That's part B. Now I'm going to stir this for 3 minutes. Oh, what's that got? That's a little bit of a ring from the bottle. Don't need that. So I'm going to stir it for 3 minutes. I'm not sure how long this one needs to be stirred, but I thought, well, it's got a longer working time than a lot of them. So I thought, well, it won't matter if I stir it a little bit longer because it's only a small board. It's only a, the board is a 30 by 30. It's MDF, which I get Bunnings to cut them the MDF into size for me. It's a 9mm. And my husband routes the edges for me so that they've got a slight curve there so the resin will just run over. Usually I tape the back, but I'm in a hurry this morning, so I'm not going to worry about taping the back on this one. Often on squares and rectangles I build the sides up, but I reinforce the sides, but especially if they're bigger ones. But this one's only 30 by 30, so I know it'll be fine. So I'm mixing the resin carefully, making sure I get all the A and the B mixed. Scraping the sides of mustard sometimes. I think it's got about either a 40 minute to 1 hour working time on this one. It's only a fairly new one that I'm using. I'm just testing it out. This resin I'm talking about. And I have to go and get some cups. I wasn't organised. And some sticks. So today I'm going to be using Lorez Sassy Red. had that for a while and I haven't used it before, so today I'm testing that out. And I'm using Artisue Plum. I'm trying to do Christmassy colours. And this one's Art Tree Creations, and it's called Grandma's Kitchen, Grandma's Garden. It's a pretty colour. And this is another Lorez, and it's called Fresh Mint. And I'm going to use a metallic pigment. It's an Artisue Bright Gold. And I might add a bit of Art Tree Creations Stargazer. It's instead of white. It's very pretty. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 colours. So I need 6 cups. So, divide my mixture up. Stargazer, I'm just going to add a little bit of that, not too much. And because this is just a test one, I'm just roughly dividing the colours up. So I'll start with Plum. That helps to open the lid sometimes if they get stuck. Ooh. This one's going quite hard in the... hope that's all right. It's gone a little bit hard. The lid mustn't have been on properly. That's no good. I will. I've got another one, I think. Used that one for a while. Not good. Okay. I'll take that out of there, throw it away. I've got one here. It's an Art Tree Creations. It's called Midnight Violet. Got a few little specks in it, but anyway, I'll get those out. So, I give that a stir and use about that much on the end of my stick. Next I'll use Sassy Red from Lorez, beautiful colour. Give that a stir, and I think about that much on the end of my stick. Beautiful colour. It's a sort of a pinky red, a deep scarlety pink red. Very pretty. should go well with the violet. And this one's Grandma's Garden. It's a powder pigment from Mica. I'll put about that much in. Beautiful colour. Actually, it's very similar to that one, to the fresh mint. I wonder if it's too close. They are close, but I'm going to add just a little touch of green. It's an Art Tree Creations green. We'll just add just a little tip of that to that one, just so that it's slightly different. A bit more different in colour than the cool mint one. It's still nice. It's still very, very close, but I'm hoping it'll be enough. Yeah, it is different, so. Okay, and this one is, I'm going to use gold, and that's an Artisue bright gold, lovely colour. About that much on the end of my stick. Very nice colour. And here I'm going to use some Stargazer. Stargazer is a powder pigment. It's probably a mica colour. And I've only got a little bit of resin there, so about that much. And what's left in my container in there as well. Very pretty. Okay, here you go. I'll start with the violet, the purple. Next I'll use the Sassy Red. And try this lovely grandma's garden with the green added to it. Looks like a very pretty colour. I like that. Next, the cool mint. Probably got a bit much resin for this size board, but never mind. Next, the gold. And finally, the sargassum. So next I'll add a little heat to move it so the heat will move around. Now I'll just tilt the board a little bit, let it run over the sides. Sorry about the reflection of the light. My husband's sneezing. Gets lots of allergies. Enough to it. I like the colour combination. Quite different. Just paper towel. I need to take shares in the paper towel company. Okay, so now I'm going to move some of the colour over. That spot is, but I don't like it. going to use my torch. Get those names in the resin, but I wonder if it's a different resin. I haven't used that one before. In my workshop, people leaving today, I've been using solid solutions and I normally use. I'm wearing my face mask. It's lacing up nicely now, isn't it? It must be a vision because I've never ever had it happen before. I'll just use the heat gun again. This one low. I love the way the lacing is happening in this. I'm going to use the same colours this afternoon in my workshop, but this time I'll be using solid solution resin, so it'll be interesting to make the difference with the same colours in the different resin. Cover my sides. why the paint's not taking, the resin's not taking too well on the sides. The one I'm using, the one I'm going to work on this afternoon is an old board that I'm going to resin over. Around the other side and make sure all the sides are covered. Well, I think that's enough. Just redo the sides again. done a little bit there. I don't know why that's happening. Okay, now I am going to attempt to bring the phone down so I can give you a close-up of that. But basically, I'm very happy with that. So bear with me for one moment while I get my phone down. And here's a close-up. Beautiful. Love the colour combination. Don't like that spot there. I might just fuse that a little bit more. Basically, that's it. This is the finished artwork. After I'd finished recording, I decided to add some amethysts and moonstones and a little glitter. I'm sorry I didn't add that to the video, but next time I do a demonstration video, I will endeavour to add gemstones. Okay, because I had some funny spots that wouldn't take resin, I added a few gemstones. I should have left the camera running, but I didn't. I didn't realise that I was going to be doing that. I wasn't planning to, but I think that fixes the problem of the spots. This is the painting that I did this afternoon with some students using the same colours as in this demonstration. I've only just learned how to do these video recordings, so if you'd like to see me do some more, please give me the thumbs up and share my work. And I thank you for watching.